sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing. Hi, welcome to Power Sewing. I'm Sandra Betsina.
And I'm Ron Collins. Here's this great upper breast pocket, but not only can you do it for the upper pocket, you can do it for the lower pocket as well. Now, the upper pocket, you're going to find this little pattern piece in your envelope. But let's say you don't have it for the lower one, which is straight across. We're going to show you how to make this little pocket pattern piece.
Okay, so I started off with the paper folded in half, and I'm going to draw a line here 4.5 inches down. Okay, then 3 inches away, I'm going to draw a line, let's see, this 2 inches.
So okay. 3 inches up from the previous line,
right.
And this is 2 inches.
This is two, okay, and this is three here. And this was four and a half, okay?
Which will be...
Now, what I'll do is I just connect those two, like that, and we'll cut it in half.
Don't cut it in half.
Oh,
but
yes,
just
I am.
Cut it out.
Well, I listen to me. Yeah, see, I'm cutting through double paper.
Right.
And so by doing that, I've been really only tracing half.
Right.
Of it. So what we end up with is something that looks like this. But now we have to do something on the corners. So a half inch in, we just go like
Give
that.
Give it a little haircut.
Yeah, so now,
and
now
there's
we
there's your pattern piece.
Okay.
So what's the next thing? We actually have that already cut out of fabric. You also want to interface that entire piece. Okay, mm-hmm. And this is using that fusible weft interfacing.
Mm-hmm.
You use it in tailored jackets, and that's the only time I use it is...
I agree.
Yeah. So what happens here, these actually become mitered. You simply just take the ends, and you bring them together, and we sew the ends both with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. So you can start sewing. Well, I always tend to start sewing at the cut edge, and you come to the point.
1/4 inch seam allowance.
1/4 inch seam allowance. And you put your 1/4 inch foot on your machine if you're not really good at eyeballing a 1/4 inch.
Let's see, fold that again kind of slow
okay.
on the other end.
Let's just... So you're taking this point here, and you're bringing it up to this cut edge there. See how
mm-hmm.
that all goes together? And we're going to sew from the cut edge to the fold.
At 1/4 inch.
At 1/4
okay.
inch. And this will self-miter the corners all by itself. It's kind of nifty.
Yeah.
And before we turn it, we're going to take, and I'm going to trim down the seam allowances like so, by half, both ends, okay? Then I'm going to just take a little bit off of each point.
Mm-hmm.
I love these scissors, Sandra, they're great. And then we're going to take, and we're going to put that on a point press, and Sandra, if you can just press that seam open and flat.
Now, you know, I've always maintained that it would be easier to press something before it was trimmed.
See, I have no problem burning my fingers. They're kind of numb after a while.
I usually do. I will press it first and then trim it, but
okay.
See, but who's doing the pressing here? Snuggy.
Oh, there we
okay,
go.
There
Are
you
go. Okay? You're good. Okay.
And here's your point turner.
Then we're going to take and we're going to turn this. We're going to turn it right sides out. Okay, here we go. Right sides out. Do we have that little pointer? Oh, you're good. I could be a surgeon and you could be my
assistant.
I don't think we should be doctors. And then... What you're going to do is
we're only good for one operation in the early morning.
So we're bringing our points out onto the corner, and you can see that this seam just self-miter itself.
Okay.
So let's point. I'm going to now, bring this point out just a little bit better.
Temporarily, I don't know where her press cloth is.
We haven't found that thing. I think we sewed it into a garment, so we're just going to use tissue paper here.
And then we're going to hit it with a clapper. See, your whole idea is that you want this to really be flat.
Okay,
let's see. Now, that looks great.
That looks really
How
good.
How about if you saw an imprint on the outside, what I would do is I'd take an envelope, because I've done this.
Okay.
I've seen it has a little problem.
And you just sandwich it in between.
I just put the corner of an envelope in there, and then I press it again.
And pound it in submission.
Yes.
Okay.
Because, see, sometimes this imprint will show through on the front. Okay.
Now, this piece of fabric here is acting like my garment, okay?
Okay.
It's not a pocket lining or anything.
Mm-hmm.
I have a placement line marked through my garment, which I'm indicating here like a basted line. What's going to happen here is you're going to take your pocket flap. You're not going to place it down. This is actually the hem of my jacket, and this would be where my shoulder seam.
Okay.
When you do this, make sure you see those mitered seams. And the reason for that, eventually what's going to happen here is this is going to flip up.
So I always say right sides together on the opposite side of the line, the opening you want it to eventually be.
See, this is one of the final stages where the seams, everything is sewn, and we're about to finish up the pocket. I machine base this down into place. And you use any stitch length you want, but machine basting is probably done at 5 or 6 mm-hmm. on your machine. And let's see here. We got issues there. Okay. I'm increasing the stitch lengths right to 6. And I'm machine basting about 1/2 inch from the cut edge. Okay.
Okay.
And there we go.
Okay.
And then I have my 2 pieces.
Okay, here are your little seams, little mitered seams. Boy, that was an easy miter, wasn't it?
It was.
Okay.
I have 2 pieces of fabric which are going to act like pocket lining.
Okay.
So one will go right above that cut edge, or the cut edge of the pocket flap, and the other one will go below it.
Okay.
And we'll pin this into place. And we'll pin this into place.
This is from the front side of the coat.
We're working all on the entire front.
Mm-hmm.
So all the construction is done to the front, and then eventually what's going to happen is we're going to cut the garment open and everything will be pressed to the wrong side. So let's just take a look what we're trying to achieve here before I tackle it, because if you've never done a pocket like this, you think, okay, where are we going with this? The bottom line here, the bottom stitching line, it is stitched from the finished edge of that pocket flap to the finished edge of the pocket flap on both ends.
So what I usually do is mark that with just a little pen mark or something.
Let's use that red Sharpie. Because I'm not going to wear this.
No, but you know, just so you feel it right there.
Right. And do the same on the other end.
Okay.
And then the upper one is running parallel to the lower one. There's 1/4 inch seam allowance between the cut edge and the stitching line. Same thing here. But do you see where we've ended the ends here? They're 1/4 inch shorter. And the reason you want to do that is, let's take a look at that final step. Is it miters the ends inside? Because the thing is, most patterns, they will ask you to run these 2 rows of stitching the same length. Okay.
And then you could never cover the opening.
That's right. What happens, it kind of looks like this.
Yes.
Instead of like that.
Mm-hmm.
So you're mitering the pocket flap, and you're mitering the pocket itself.
Okay.
So we're going to sew that. Make sure we go back to a regular stitch length. And what I do here is, if you really know your sewing machine, I tell you, really know your sewing machine, you can bring the needle down into the fabric, and you can kind of feel whether you're going through just the garment and lining, or if you're going through the pocket flap, because you want to go through the pocket flap. And let's decrease our stitch lengths down to 1. And you can do a lock stitch, or you can just do this tiny little stitch. Do that for about a half inch, and then we'll go back
and
to a regular.
You're not using the typical lining fabric that's, you know, slippery stuff. This is just a nice firm cotton. In men's jackets, they call it pocketing fabric, but just a nice firm cotton. Or if it's for winter coat, often I'll use cotton flannel.
I'm going to take a pin and put it right at the end, because the thing is, one thing you don't want to do here is you don't want to sew beyond that pin. So decrease your stitch length, because it's much easier to sew.
And the pin is the last little piece of fabric that's right with the pocket
See,
flap.
See, one more stitch. There we go. Okay. Now, that was the tricky one. The one above it is a walk in the park.
Okay.
So the one above it, quarter inch between the cut edge of the pocket lining and the seam, and it's going to be a quarter inch shorter. I secure the ends with a small stitch or a reverse stitch. And let's go back to regular stitch length.
And the pocketing fabric is cut 1 inch longer on each end than the flap. So if you have a 6-inch flap, you want to cut it 8 inches wide.
Correct.
And that looks about 6 inches long.
We'll get rid of these threads at the end.
Okay.
It's funny how some people sew and they'll sew a whole garment without clipping one thread.
They're in a big hurry.
Now, before we cut this open, what we want to do is we want to remove this basted seam.
Oh, that held down the flap.
That's right. It's done its duty. Because sometimes if you don't do this, the pocket flap shifts on you.
Okay.
So we're just going to simply remove that seam, or basted seam, I should say. Got it from that end?
I was thinking of underneath here. Yeah. Sometimes if I use that basting thread in the bobbin, I can just pull it.
Slides out.
But let's see.
There we go. Okay. You've done that a few times, haven't
mm-hmm.
you?
Okay. So, I know a few things here today.
Yeah. So there's that basted seam coming out.
Okay.
So we want to get in here.
Now one little thing here. Let's take a look at this. One of the things you want to make sure, this is fine, but just make sure that this length and this length are the same, because otherwise your flap won't be the same. And so before you start turning it through, just take a look at that.
Okay. And make sure your ends are well secured. So what I'm doing here is I'm pulling the lining up, and you want to make sure that this isn't coming apart.
Right.
So what we're going to do now, this is like being a surgeon. You're going to go in between those lips, and you're going to snip into the jacket. And you're going to cut down the center. You're going to stop a quarter inch away from the shortest stitching line, which is this one here. You're going to cut to the corners, but you don't want to cut through the pocket lining. You see, there's the end of that, the end of the stitch.
So fold that out of the way.
Fold it out of the way, and then continue to cut right to the stitching line.
Perfect.
Okay, you see how that looks?
Then
we're going to do the same thing with this one up here, but you want, here again, you want to move out the lining, and you want to move out the seam allowance of that little pocket flap.
Of the pocket flap.
And we're working with a pretty bulky fabric here, which is...
So you're only cutting through the coat itself.
Exactly.
Or a little bit of interfacing. You know, always put a little interfacing behind any pocket that you do.
Well, when I do a tailored jacket like the one I have there, the entire front is all interfaced.
Yeah.
Would you put an additional layer of interfacing behind the pockets? No.
No.
You're just asking for trouble.
Unless... On a woman's jacket, I will usually, if I'm interfacing the whole front, I'll interface it with the interfacing on the bias, because it forms better over the curves.
And well, then, women have more curves than men. Well, you hope so anyways.
Well, then my interface, I would add another interfacing piece that's parallel to the grain line so it doesn't stretch out of shape. Okay?
Okay. So now remember, all this construction was done on the front of the garment. So let's bring that iron over.
Okay.
Now basically, this is when it becomes probably a little more challenging, not in the sewing department, but the pressing. What I do here is I take the top lining and I press it down.
Away from the stitching.
Away from the stitching. And I do the same to the bottom. My pocket flap is still
in the down position.
I'm going to bring it to the up position.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to press that. And then I'm going to take my pocket lining, the top and the bottom, and I'm going to push it through that opening. Okay?
Now, can I tell you just one thing that I have found? See, working on a woman's garment, sometimes it'll be a loose tweed or some or linen. So what I usually do before I turn it through, I take that basting stitch out.
Okay.
Because do you see if it was really a loose tweed, and then by the time I get this pulled through, I can make a hole in it.
Right.
But on a firm fabric, you don't have to worry about it.
So then what happens here is this pocket flap. Let's just bring it over. You see how now the pocket flap is into the up mode. Okay. This is working from the wrong side. Now starting at the top, you see what's happening here? This is exactly what we want. See this quarter inch fold? Don't press it down. Just keep that quarter inch fold going up.
Let it, okay.
Okay, we'll press that. And these little triangles at each end, what you want there is you want them to be pressed up
and back.
And I think with tailoring, you'll spend more time pressing, grading, and trimming than you do sewing.
But it makes a big difference.
Big difference. Now this is the bottom of the pocket. Okay, this is coming down here again. You see those little quarter inch folds? That's what you want.
Okay.
So we'll press that. Now this pocket is going to come down like so. One pocket lining is going to be a little bit longer than the other, but who cares, because this is all inside the jacket. But we're just going to leave that for now, because I want to show you what's happening on the front. Look at this. Okay? And I'm just going to give a little bit better job here in pressing those mitered ends inside the pocket. Okay? So you can see this is looking pretty darn good, but I think we got to hit it, Sandra.
Oh, yes, my favorite part.
Yes. Whack it.
Now, I would be doing a press cloth on top of this because I'd be worried.
So here we are. Look at those ants. Okay, there's our little mitered seam. There's a little mitered ant. Now, what do you do here, Sandra? Do you hand stitch that down?
I used to hand stitch it from the front, but I found that you could see it. So now what I do is, after I close up the pocket, I hand whip it from the back with beeswax thread.
That's right.
Is that what you do?
That's what I do.
Okay.
Now so this is hand stitched down. And then what happens is we have to finish the back of the pocket.
See, that would be hand stitching this, right? You'd actually come right in here. See, I usually close up the pocket, and then I do my little hand stitching.
Oh, really?
Catch it.
See, I do, this is what I do. I do the hand stitching first.
Okay.
And then I close it up.
Doesn't matter, either
whatever
way.
Looks the best.
But don't try to hand sew it from this side, because you can always see it. So I'd run beeswax thread and just kind of hand whip it. Okay.
Now, let's say you made this pocket, and it's too deep. What I do here, can you pass me the scissors? I just cut the pocket lining that's facing towards me shorter. I just cut one of them, not the other. And then I take the bottom two edges and I bring them together. And I sew that at, well, roughly a quarter inch seam allowance. So let's see what happens here when you have one shorter pocket lining and one longer. So I'll just quickly sew. This is the bottom of the pocket. This, we haven't done anything to the sides yet.
Okay.
Tell you, when I mastered this pocket, I was a happy man.
Yeah.
Because all men's jackets, tailored jackets, have this pocket.
It's here. Okay.
Okay. Now, this is coming down, and you see this little trick? for the longest time, I would cut them the same length.
So the nice thing about this is you have your seam allowance on the back of the pocket toward the body, and no seam showing on the front of the
body.
That's
right. And another thing, too, is that the bottom of your pocket is never going to open up because there's no seam. And you get less of a bulk happening coming from the front. Then what I do on the sides is I take the garment facing me, I bring it back, and I stitch the ends.
Do you try? Where's the little triangle?
Oh, sorry, my friend. Let's see. Little triangle is at the end, but they're on an angle.
Angle, right. Okay.
So what's going to happen is when you get to that little triangle, you're going to have to angle your stitching line.
Yeah, that's what I want, because you want to catch that little triangle in.
Right. So I'm coming up. I'm going to stop with needle down here. I'm going to put part of the garment underneath the pressure foot because I want to snug right up into the corner of the pocket. So there we go. Not a bad idea to decrease my stitch lengths at this time. Down to about 1.0. Stop with needle down. Okay. Pressure foot up. And I'm just going to angle this just slightly, because those little pies don't come straight out at the end. They come up on an angle.
And you do want to anchor those down.
Yes. There we go. And of course you would do the other side too. But let's just take a look from the wrong side here. You can see how I angled this to catch that little pie.
Yes.
At the end.
So you came up, when you were on the machine, you came up this way and then folded the top of the garment
back.
This way. So
that's right.
Very nice.
Don't
you beautiful
like that?
Pocket. Beautiful.
And let's take a look inside. And you can see how that is all nicely stitched, nice and secured.
Mm-hmm.
And then your hand, of course, this would be stitched down. What do
beautiful.
You think?
Did a great job.
Thank
I think it's
you.
A great job.
We make a good team, don't we?
That is a nice pocket. Well, thank you for watching Power Sewing. Thank you, Ron.
You're welcome.
So what do you think?
About what?
Power Sewing.